sons are. Joyfully all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, glory to the coming King.
Let the heralds, angels sing, glory to the coming King. It's on earth and mercy mild, God and man, let them smile. Joyfully all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, glory to the coming King.
Rise, O people, hear the call of the Lamb.
Jammies! Jammies! Wake up! You must come and see this!
Oh, no! It's too early. I'm not the Magi you're looking for.
And how late did you stay up last night?
It still is last night.
Oh, Jammies.
I was reading about witchcraft. Then I was reading about handicrafts. And then World of Warcraft, and I guess I ended up playing Minecraft all night. They're like little electronic Legos.
How will we ever become great and powerful magicians if we're always slacking off playing games?
Correction. You want to be the great magician. I just want to be the greatest wizard enchanter known to mankind.
That's right. And together we shall rule the world.
Nothing can stand in our way.
That's why we're such good friends.
You're great.
No, you're great.
I know that. All right, so you got me up. What is so all-fired-up important that you had to disturb my nightly winks?
That's right. I almost forgot.
Why you've got your telescope?
Jambres, this is the biggest news of the century. The alignment of the constellations. A new photosphere among the intergalactic realm.
What?
It must be a divine, celestial aura. Yeah. The first ever stationary cosmic flare in the entire universe.
Balthazar, B. B, look at your roommate, look at your best friend. Do your breathing. Okay. All right, now we're going to go again, because all I got out of that was galactic and naked. All right? I know. Let's go again. Layman's terms for those of us who are not astronomers.
I'm sorry. I can't help it.
That's
I was
okay.
Up tossing and turning in my bed all night, and I couldn't get my beauty sleep.
That shows.
Well, I realized it was because there was this light shining through my window. Mm-hmm. So I went and looked yonder, and guess what I saw? Guess!
Just tell me.
It was the brightest star I had ever seen. It was as if the heavens were trying to tell me something.
The heavens? Trying to tell you something? You're sure of it? Well, what did you do?
Well, I popped in a melatonin and went back to sleep. But when I woke up this morning, the same star was still right there. It was as if the heavens were communicating something to me. So I looked through my scrolls of astrology and found, well, nothing. But then I recall an old magi by the name of Balaam, whose prophecy is old as legend. I remember it goes something like, a star will come out of Jacob, a scepter will rise out of Israel, and shall smite the head of Moab and destroy the people of Sheth. There must be great power in that star.
Let me just take a look. Balthazar. This could be the solution to all of our questions.
Pack
all of our
your
problems.
Things,
you
Jambres.
And I can harness the power and rule the world together.
Let's pack our things.
Let's pack.
Now, let's see here. I've calculated the constellations.
Yoda socks.
And let's see here. And according to my GPS, the gemstone positioning spell, right. It appears to be pointing. West!
Disinfectant. Let's see here. Advil. Okay, I think that's everything. All right, I'm ready. Now I can finally be the greatest wizard enchanter of the world.
And I can finally discover the secrets of immortality and become the greatest magician of all time.
And the world will kneel at our feet.
Jambres, this is going to change our lives forever.
Indeed.
And don't forget to pack the spicy
sweet chili Doritos. They're going in the satchel.
That's why we're such good friends.
Hit it.
This forest wraps around just like a pretzel. I should have brought my magic carpet. I could have seen this in a whole new world. Ah, good to see all your smiling faces. My name is Melchior. I am a seer from the land of Arabia. This is my looking glass. I can see through this, break the fourth wall, and talk to all of you charming people. Now, to catch you up on exactly what's been happening, a few moons ago, a bright and shining star appeared in the west. I knew right away that this was some mystical phenomenon. But who knows what could be under that star. Maybe it was a pot of gold, like at the end of a rainbow. Maybe it was a
hidden treasure.
Or maybe it was something even better, like a PlayStation 5. Those are hard to find. I could be the wealthiest and happiest seer in the whole world.
Jambres?
Yes?
Do you have any potions for these pesky mosquitoes?
I'm not an apothecary. I'm an enchanter, remember? Hey, you want me to hypnotize them?
No, forget
You're
it.
You're getting sleepy, mosquito.
Never mind.
You're getting sleepy. You're getting sleepy.
It must be this orange blossom essential oil lotion I put on my face. Should have gone with the tea tree scent, don't you think?
Anything to make you smell better. By the way, I thought we were going west. Why are we going east? Why are we in the woods?
Well, we took a needed detour for a quick errand.
We're not alone.
What is it?
We're not alone, Balthazar. Stand over here. I'm going to pull him out with a spell. Got to think of a good one. Honolulu, Mississippi. Alabama, Obama, old Biden, oh boy. Come out! Come on! Who are you? Are you listening to us?
Melchior, is that you?
Balthazar, what are you doing here?
What, you know each other?
Jambres, this is Melchior. We studied wizardry together years ago in Babylon.
I can't believe I ran into you. How crazy is that?
Whoa, are you guys all right? I mean, I have Advil.
You just had a premonition, didn't you?
I did. You're on a quest to follow the star as well.
I have Advil.
How did we know that?
Yeah, how do we know that? I'm still trying to find the Advil.
Well, you see, Melchior is a seer from the land of Arabia. He can see things unseen.
You can see things unseen?
Yes.
Is that right? How many fingers do I have behind my back?
Four.
Oh, shoot.
I have been studying these Babylonian scrolls of prophecy over and over. It's revealed hints of this coming power, according to one of Babylon's greatest magi, Daniel.
That's right. His cryptic prophecies have never been fully understood.
Wait, who's Daniel?
Well, Daniel was a Hebrew servant to Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon. One night he had a terrible dream and insisted all the magi interpret it without telling them what he saw.
Well, sounds fair.
The king would have killed all the magi if Daniel hadn't spoken up. In fact, it was because of Daniel that the magi and his god was known, well known throughout all the land.
That's right. Our ancestors owe their lives to Daniel.
Well, what was his prophecy?
All right, let me get out my scrolls here. These are really, really old, and sometimes they're hard to pull out, so give me just a bit here. Ah, look here. Mm. It says, a period of 70 sets of seven has been decreed for your people and your holy city. See right there?
I see.
To finish their rebellion, to put an end to their sin, to atone for their guilt, to bring in everlasting righteousness, to confirm the prophetic vision, and to anoint the most holy place.
That sounds like a lot of math. What does all that mean?
Well, I don't really know, but the dates seem to be aligning, and the star has appeared in the west. There must be some great power at that holy place.
That's why we must be the first to discover it. Melchior, you should join us on our quest. We could sure use someone with your abilities, and then maybe we could all get what we seek of this holy place.
Well, sure, that sounds like a great plan, but why were you coming from this direction in the forest?
Indeed.
I'm glad you asked.
Yeah, I asked it too.
You see, this forest contains a particular semaphorous species that when you cut into its bark, elicits a sap-like substance, also known as myrrh.
Wait a minute. Sap? Syrup? You do know that we ducked into the food sphinx in Damascus. I had some coupons. We could have got that.
No, not syrup. Myrrh. It's a particularly valuable substance. Google says it has particular healing properties. It can cure asthma, coughs, cold sores, leprosy, and of course, mosquito bites.
Ah, that's right. You're making an immortality potion, aren't you?
Well, that's right. I'm hoping that we can harness the power of that holy place and fuse it together with the myrrh to create an elixir of immortality.
Oh, great. You've been bothering me about immortality forever. Now you're saying that you're going to have forever to bother me? This trip's getting better all the time.
Well, now that you've got what you've come for, can we please get on with our quest?
Oh, that's right. The map. Well, since we took a needed detour, according to the GPS, now it's pointing on that direction. We need to go through, looks like Nazareth, from the east.
From the east. After you. And we still haven't found love.
Is not going to set itself. Gasper?
Yes? All right, I'm coming, Mother. Sorry about that. I had to finish this project. Here, look what I made.
Oh, not again, Gasper. Last time you invented something, you blew up my oven.
Yeah, but I mean, it also cooked the chicken, right? All right, look, with this invention, I'll be known as the smartest and wisest man in the whole world. This could solve all of our problems, Mother.
Well, what does it do?
All right. So this, it gets rid of the smell in the bathroom.
Wait, the smell?
Yeah, you know, the smell.
The smell, okay.
All right, so here, look. All right. So what you do is you put in a scent in this little compartment here. Mm-hmm. Then you light the candle and you turn the switch to activate this fan here. Mm-hmm. And there you go.
Well, what happened?
Like I said, it gets rid of the smell in the bathroom. So I think I'm going to call it maybe the deodorifier. Nah. The poopery. No, that's not it either. Anyway, problem is I can't find a scent that is strong enough to defeat the monstrous smell.
Oh, that stinks. Gasper, I think what you need is frankincense.
Where? What's that?
Frankincense. It's this spice they used in the temple for worship. Gasper, I can remember when I was a little girl, your grandfather would say to me, "Rosita, let your life be like frankincense, a sweet aroma to the Lord." Gasper, your grandfather was so loud. That was back when I used to go to the church and worship the Lord. But, you know, since I've had this cafe, it just takes up all my time. You should be at the temple, though. You know, you could acquire some frankincense there.
But, Mother, I've never gone anywhere outside of Nazareth before, especially not without you. I don't think I can do it. I'm too afraid of disappointing you.
Oh, you know you're my number one supporter. I'm your number one supporter. It's two-way street. But, you know, I think it's about time you maybe spend less time on the screen and let your dreams find legs and discover your calling.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't know my calling. Maybe I'll receive a sign.
Well, until then, let's set up this cafe.
Hey, look, it's the Nazareth Cafe. Oh, let's stop in for some drinks, shall we? I am parched.
Not a bad idea.
But great timing. We just ran out of those spicy sweet chili Doritos.
I know.
Be careful over there. It's really close to the edge.
Yeah, it is. That's okay. It couldn't be as dangerous as the chicken salad I had at that camel truck stop in the Negev.
Yeah.
That was a mistake.
Welcome to Nazareth Cafe. I'm Rosita. What can we get for you guys today?
Hey, I think most of us will have three pineapple juices.
Three pineapple juices? We are known for our pineapple punches.
I'll have a diet cheer wine if you got it.
Okay.
I don't have diet, but they do have this on the market. So if you guys want to try that out,
solid.
I can't imagine it being very successful, but you can give us feedback, okay?
Is that a local flavor?
It is.
Okay.
Well, gentlemen, I hate to say this, but I think we need to ask for directions.
What? Men don't ask. Magi do not ask for directions. Let me see this. How hard could it be?
All right, gentlemen, here are your drinks. Hang on.
Thank you.
Is that a gemstone positioning spell map? GPS? I've never seen one in person before, only in my books. Mm-hmm. It says that only highly trained magi have access to these. I didn't know that just anybody from the streets could get
access to
them.
Just anybody from the streets. Now come.
B, do you breathe in?
Young man.
Do you breathe in?
We are magi from a distant kingdom on a quest to follow a star.
Do you breathe in?
Oh, no way. You mean the bright star that just appeared a few days ago. See, I've read every astronomy book out there, and I have no idea what that is. Mm. It's out of this world.
It's because it is not from this world. I've searched all the scrolls of astrology, and this only appears in the ancient prophetic texts.
Not all of the mysteries have been revealed through these prophetic texts. Takes a while. Excuse me.
It's okay. Build suspense.
Interesting. Well, may I take a look at it?
Sure.
Let's see. It says, a period of 70 sets of seven has been decreed for your people. All right, well, that means 70 sets of seven, which is a weeks times 70, which equals 490 days, which is roughly equivalent to 16.1096 months.
What just happened?
It's a human calculator.
Do we have an estimated period of when this prophecy starts?
Oh, yeah. It says right here, down below, it says, a period of 70 sets of seven has been decreed for your people. No one understand this. From the time the world goes out to restore and rebuild Jerusalem till the anointed place.
Fascinating. So that was 457 years ago when the Persian king Artaxerxes made a decree which gave permission to all the Jews who so desired to return to Jerusalem and restore the city. So then, if 457 years ago was the starting point, then that would put the fulfillment of this prophecy 3 days, 6 months, and 487 years ago.
No, that doesn't sound right. Don't forget about the day for a year principle. Sometimes when dealing with prophecy, one day equals a year.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so then that would mean 490 literal years would put the prophecy fulfillment exactly 33 years from today. Yeah.
Boy, what is this wizardry you've just cast?
Oh.
It's pretty good, this.
Not that I was listening, but Gasper is very gifted with numbers. He's, in fact, the smartest kid in Nazareth. I have it on a bumper sticker.
Well, maybe he could figure out why our gemstone positioning spell isn't working.
Oh, sir, here in Nazareth, we only worship the Lord of Heaven. We don't look to any other necromancy or other spirits, so he kindly put that away.
Yes, ma'am.
Now.
Although, if I may, you might notice the star seems to be moving as if it wants us to follow its light. Perhaps the most holy place would be in the temple.
Wait, Gaspar, did you just say the most holy place? Where did you get this? What is this?
It's in the Babylonian prophecy.
I read this as a child. This isn't just the Babylonian prophecy. This is the sacred scrolls from our prophet Daniel.
So you have heard of this most holy place?
Meshachadesh. Not just most holy place. It can also be translated as most holy one.
Most holy one. A period of 70 sets of seven has been decreed for your people in your holy city to finish their rebellion, to put an end to their sin, to atone for their guilt, to bring in everlasting righteousness, to confirm the prophetic vision, and to anoint the most holy one.
These must be the dates for the start of his reign, 33 years from now, that is.
Gentlemen, we've been looking at this wrong. We're not looking for a place. We're looking for a person. And the star must be a sign
of his great power.
Of his great power.
Must be a sign.
We must be searching for a new king.
A king of Jews.
Well, this king must indeed be at Jerusalem temple. I must offer him my myrrh to try and favor get power. Gaspar, could you lead us to Jerusalem temple?
I guess I can. I'm not sure, Mother.
Oh, Gaspar, you absolutely must go. I mean, this is an awesome opportunity for you. Maybe you could find your calling. Here, take this, and maybe you can find some frankincense along your travel as well.
But Mother, this is everything we have.
Now, Gaspar, you're everything I have. If you get one scratch on my boy...
We will take good care of him, Rosita. We should be going now.
Yes, yes. Yes.
Thank you for your hospitality.
Gaspar, I'm so proud of you.
After this quest, we must go to Salisbury. Mystical
Bye,
place.
Mother. I'll bring you a souvenir.
Oh, thank you, Gaspar. I wear a medium. I'll work on it after the holidays. I wonder if this could be... the Messiah, the anointed one that's going to save our people. This is such good news.
King Herod, did you call for Simeon, the temple priest, and Nicodemus, the teacher of the law?
Yes, I did. Send them in.
It is not often that our presence is requested in this palace.
What can we do for you, Your Majesty?
Every night this week, when I'm trying to rest, look out my window, there's this bright, shining star. It's keeping me awake at night. None of my other magi seem to know what's going on. Do you know anything about this?
We too have seen the star, but we are uncertain as to its meaning.
Perhaps it is a sign from the Lord.
The Lord hasn't spoken through the prophets for the last 400 years. What makes you think he wants to talk now?
Well, since the star appears to be resting directly above Bethlehem, it could be the fulfillment of the prophet Micah, of a newborn king.
What?
The prophecy states, Bethlehem, though you are lowly among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me a ruler over my people Israel, one whose origin is from ancient times, days of old.
It goes on to say that this ruler will be born to shepherd, walking in the name of the Lord, and his greatness will reach the ends of the earth. That's what it says. Now it's up to you, King Herod, whether you choose to believe this or not.
Sounds like foolishness to me.
Ah, foolish to you, but to our people, it is the sign of the coming Messiah. Oh, how I've waited for him so long.
Oh, how I've wondered.
How unsettling.
King Herod, there are four Magi out in the east gates. It appears they are here to worship you.
Well, what are you waiting for? Send them on in.
For the signs in the heavens may lead us to you, to you. Bringing our humble offerings to you, to you.
From the distant land of Persia. Seeking immortality, I bring the gift of myrrh, the fruit of the earth, the nectar of life, in the hopes that the holy air will bind us to this great prophet. And this is my roommate and best friend.
I am Jambres, from Egypt, southern Egypt, an enchanter, a seeker, a magi's apprentice. Here to seek the great high priest who will grant me fame and power and glory among the gods.
People have long believed that a sign will show itself in the cosmos. And behold, I have seen a vision of a great king whose kingdom will never end. And behold, a sign has appeared in the west, a star. I am here for my own wealth and riches from the one they call the King of the Thank you.
Jewish God. We set out to seek a newborn baby. That's what we will do. So God, you gave us a sign from the Lion of Judah, an astrological phenomenon. We traveled afar, guided by a ball of flames, a king star. My name is Gasper, dreamer, to be a scholar, and silver is the gift I carry to offer. You have what I need, this is common sense. I just tag along for some frankincense. Let's make a trade, and we can be done. Of the wise men, I'm known as the youngest one.
Balaam's prophecy. A star will come out of Jacob. A scepter will rise out of Israel and shall smite the head of Moab and destroy the people of Sheth.
If I may ask, do you know the whole prophecy?
Well, not really.
Ha! Gentiles seek knowledge only to be made fools. There was more to Balaam's message than just the star.
All right, who is this guy?
This is Nicodemus, a member of the Jewish ruling council, and I, Simeon, a temple priest. Together we have studied the scripture more than anyone. The prophecy of Balaam says that whoever hears the word of God and receives dreams and visions from him will know the truth. Whoever falls in worship of this king, their eyes will be opened.
The prophecy goes on to say, I see him but not near, I behold him but not now. A star will rise out of Jacob, and a scepter will come forth from Israel, and he will crush the foreheads of his enemies.
I am a powerful seer from my land. With my looking glass, I can see what I want clearly. I have no need of some god to show me something. I am here for my own prosperity.
The mysteries of God are hidden to those who seek after idols, so that they will forever be seeing but never perceive.
Yes, go back to your own land. What you're looking for is not here.
Now, wait a second. They came here to see me. So, Nicodemus, Simeon, thank you very much for your time, but that'll be all. Guard, please escort them out of the...
Forsake your quest.
Everyone, get out.
But King Herod... This is no ordinary sign.
Thank you very much for your time.
The one that they call the Messiah, the Holy One.
Goodbye.
Wait.
Didn't want to make a long car trip with him.
Holy One? That's what Daniel called the king.
I can tell you everything you need to know about this king.
Well, please tell us so that we may go and worship him.
This may be only just a small child. This king may not be able to give you what you're looking for.
Indeed. But if he is the most holy one, the Messiah, then maybe he has something greater than what we are looking for. Perhaps we don't know what we're seeking.
Are you suggesting there's something greater than riches or immortality or fame?
If this child is who the Jews say he is, the Messiah, the Savior of the world, then who are we to make request of him? It is up to us to understand why the heavens sent a savior. That is the real mystery.
Ah, then this must be a noble quest indeed. I will send you to Bethlehem to find this child king and report back to me. I'll send you with a caravan, three camels and three Chick-fil-A gift cards.
Oh, well, all right.
Sounds pretty good.
All right.
That's more like it.
So everyone's
ready
to go.
What about my frankincense?
Yeah. Guard, bring us some frankincense.
You got any more cheer wine?
Here you go, sir. 10 pounds of silver.
I really don't need, well, yes, I do. Let's see, very good. As I said, the only thing I ask of you, when you find this child king, report back to me. Let me know where he is, so that I may go and worship him as well.
As you wish, king.
Very good. Don't forget the frankincense. All right, make sure you have a good journey. Mm-hmm. Make sure you come back to me. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry, do you validate we had a double humper
guard,
out here?
You can go ahead and escort him out.
Someone put a boot on that. Go.
Somebody put a boot on our double humper?
Fools.
You should have stayed with the sheep.
Okay, if an angel came to you and told you that the Messiah was born, would you want to stay back and watch the sheep?
Listen, we cannot tell Mom and Dad that we just left the sheep all by themselves in the fields, okay?
Really? I run off leaving them in the fields all the time.
Running off doing what exactly?
Crying wolf?
Mm-hmm, okay.
I can't believe we just witnessed the birth of the Messiah.
I can't believe this is what I chose to wear today to meet the Messiah.
You look fine. Listen, this was a fun trip, like bucket list items checked off, memories. But can we please just head back and forget that any of this ever happened?
What? How can we? Angels came to us. Stryda thought it was a ghost and peed a little, and the angel had to say, don't be afraid. How can we not tell anybody what we just witnessed?
First of all, Stryda, that's really nasty. I thought we broke that habit. And second of all, I'm the oldest, so I get to make the rules around here. Let's go.
Wait a minute. Why do you get to make the rules? Age is irrelevant. The angels came to all of us. We all saw the baby. Don't you want to just tell the whole world about it?
I do, but Nazi, Stryda, who's going to believe us? I mean, we're just lowly shepherds.
Why do you think the news came to us? Why not kings?
Well, because, well, I don't know. I haven't done my research yet. But what I do know is that this was not what was supposed to happen.
Don't you see? God came for people like us, like me, the outcasts, the lowly, the weirdos, and the little sister that everyone always overlooks and forgets.
Peace, I must tell someone about this or I'm going to explode.
That's a bit dramatic. Oh, Massacre, we don't know them.
Are you sure this is the way to Bethlehem?
I'm pretty sure.
I'm pretty doubtful. I'll tell you what, there's some weird-looking creatures in the woods over here. Let's go into the field. And by the way, has anybody given any thought to how we're going to find this child, this holy Messiah child thing, when we get to Bethlehem? The place is going to be packed because of the census.
I have a better question. How do we know that this Messiah will grant us what we are looking for? Perhaps we do not know what we are seeking.
Pull yourself together, yeah, Melchior. Really. Perhaps the star can shed some light on all of these things.
Just flash that winning smile. We'll be fine.
Excuse me, sir. Are you looking for the Messiah?
Massey, how many times have I told you to not talk to strangers?
We heard you talking about a star. Were you visited by extraterrestrial beings as well?
Stryo, can't you follow directions? Guys, I'm sorry. You look like, you know, rich kings on a mission. We'll be on our way now.
That's
gross.
Right. Magi, I have no business with shepherds. Come along, gentlemen.
Onward.
Wait. Did you say Messiah?
Forget it. You wouldn't believe us if you told you.
Try us.
An angel came to us tonight and told us the place for the Messiah.
Oh, excuse me. Oh, man, I snarfed that. Occupational hazard. I'm sorry, I find it difficult to believe that an angel with a heavenly message would bypass wise and learned people and come to, well, you. I mean, you're young and uneducated and a little ripe, actually. No offense.
Excuse me. Okay, that's it. You cannot talk to me and my siblings that way. You spoiled, selfish rich men. No offense. Now listen, an angel did don't mock me. No, an angel did appear to us. We may not have cool gadgets or ancient scrolls like that, or even powers. Maybe we do stink a little, but I can't afford my perfume, okay? Mm-hmm. But listen, we were invited to meet the King of Kings and learn his name. Do you even know his name?
She's bluffing. She's bluffing, right? Let me handle this. Dears, perhaps I was a little hasty. Tell us what you know, and I'll share my Doritos with you.
We don't need your gift. The Messiah has already given us everything that we need. What is that?
Get out.
Wait, what did he give you? What did he give you, power, riches?
He gave us nothing this world could give us.
Really?
Yeah, and we're not going to tell you guys until you apologize.
That is ridiculous. Well, what?
Balthazar, let me apologize for my friend. He doesn't get out much. Kind of embarrassing sometimes. Please, tell us, what did he give you that we may go and worship him?
He gave us hope.
Hope.
Hope that even the least of these could have a chance to be in his presence.
An angel appeared to us and said, "Do not be afraid, for we bring great news that will cause joy to all the people.
Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord."
This will be the sign to you.
Wait.
You will find...
Don't tell them that yet. How do we know that you're seeking the baby for the right reasons?
Yeah, what if you heard him?
Hey, we are Magi. We would never stoop to something so low. We simply want to meet the Messiah, harness his power, take it back to our land, exploit it, and rule the world.
See, all you want to do is take. Like kings, all that you care about is how powerful or rich you are.
When you say it like that, it sounds bad.
It's because it is bad. Now the wheels are turning. The Messiah is a gift from heaven to us. It should be treasured.
The angels came to us singing, "Glory to God in the highest heaven." And on earth's peace to those whom his favor rests.
Each of us gave him the glory that he deserved, because he has come to bring us peace on earth.
You know, my mother used to tell me about the promise of the Messiah and how he will right what is wrong and fix what's been broken. If he is the Messiah, then he's the king that will save all of our people.
No, this is not making any sense at all. How can this Messiah King save us from anything? How can he bring peace to the world? He's just a baby.
Perhaps that he may suffer our pain and take our place.
Wait, how did you come up with that, Melchior?
Have you read the rest of Daniel's prophecy?
No, I'm still working on Little Women.
I can see that. I've read it over and over, but I was troubled at this last part. It says, after the 62 sevens, the Anointed One will be put to death and will have nothing. He will confirm a covenant with many for 1 7. In the middle of the seven, he will put an end to sacrifice and offering until the end that is decreed is poured out on him.
But what does it all mean?
It sounds to me like this Messiah, this Anointed One, will be the atoning sacrifice for the sins of the world, bringing about world peace. Now I see, he is the gift from God to us, the hope that death, destruction, and desolation will be poured out on him, and not us.
Hang on, 70 sevens are decreed for your people and your holy city to finish transgression, to put an end to sin, to atone for wickedness, to bring in everlasting righteousness, and to seal up vision and prophecy, and to anoint the most holy one. This all makes sense now. He is here to save our people from our sins. This is incredible.
That is what we have been trying to tell you all this whole time.
Mary, his mother, told us that's what his name means, salvation of God.
What is his name, that we may go and worship him for what he has done for us?
His name is Jesus. Jesus, our Lord and Savior.
So this Jesus will one day sacrifice himself so that we may all have peace with God. All this time I've been chasing immortality. And now I find my quest is leading me to this newborn, this king sent from heaven to pardon my sin, take my place, so that I might have eternal life. I don't know what to do. I'm too ashamed.
If he was willing to receive someone like us, I'm sure he would be willing to receive you.
You will find him wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
You know, at first, I thought that this was something that we must keep to ourselves. It didn't feel right. But now, you girls have really shown me that this is something that we must spread to the world.
Indeed. It appears the Savior has come from the least to the greatest. Thank you, Massey Stryer and Peace, for sharing with us the truth that you have witnessed. It must have been his masterpiece plan the whole time.
All right, thank you all so much for listening, and we hope we helped. But we really must get back now and tell our parents about this great news.
Don't forget about the whole village.
And then the whole world. Bye!
Well, that's over.
If this is the one my people have been searching for, then so must I. This is going to sound crazy, but I want to give him my frankincense as a gift.
What? Gasper, after all you went through to get it, you're just gonna give away your frankincense. It's crazy.
I don't know what's crazier, to give him my prized possession or to believe he's who they say he is, but then give him nothing at all.
I agree. This is crazy.
Thank you.
I agree with Gasper.
What?
If children and shepherds must go to give him glory, then so must I.
No. This is insane. Well, what you gonna give him?
Well,
Gaspar, what do you think you could give him?
Do you have anything precious or valuable? If you have no gift, then do you have any talents? Do you know how to play the drums? Pa-rum-pum-pum-pum.
No. But I do have something. This is my looking glass. It's made of pure gold. I can give this to him as my offering if he says...
Stop. I've heard enough. Would you listen to yourself? And you too. Frankincense. Gold. This is how you make your living, Melchior. You're basically going to give your life's work to some Jewish child on the word of children who claim they have seen an angel. Guys, this is insane. Balthazar, tell them.
This myrrh was my hope in finding immortality. Now I must also offer it to him as a gift, to the one who will give himself completely so that all may have peace with God.
I think my head's going to explode. Balthazar, you're thinking about submitting to this Jewish Messiah child. Don't you want to be the world's greatest magician? It's all you ever talked about. How can you submit and be the world's greatest magician? Don't you want that?
I do, Jambres, but...
Well, all right.
Peace with God is more important than any other power. If this Messiah King can bring peace to the earth, then he is worthy of our worship.
No. No, Balthazar, that was not the quest. That was not the goal. The goal is to get the power, get the fame, rule the world. That was our quest. This is not their quest. They have hijacked our quest. Now you have got to make a choice. Are you going to stand with me, or are you going to kneel before this child?
No jamborees. I must choose to either trust the Messiah or trust myself. It doesn't have to be this way, Jamrys. You can still come with us and see. He can mend everything that's broken.
Accept our friendship. Goodbye, Balthazar. This is where our paths part ways.
Where would you go?
I'll go back to Egypt. I'll find fame. I'll find glory. I'll find honor. All on my own. All for myself. I'll show all of you.
Jamrys, stop! Please don't walk away!
Well, what should we do now?
Balthazar, I really hate to break up your friendship. Should we follow him to Egypt?
No. No, we must complete the quest, follow the star, and find the king who is the hope of the world. Perhaps we can find hope for our lost friend there as well.
Call him into thou, down to thou down.
the hope of the world.
Had a premonition.
What was it?
It was a warning. It was a warning to not return to King Herod.
Then let's return to our own country by a different route.
One king held the purest gold. One king held the hope of the
So, I give those wise men one thing to do. Go find this child king and report back to me. Instead, they disappeared. That's fine. I've got tricks up my sleeve as well. Guard, take your men, go down to Bethlehem. Kill every firstborn child there under one, no, make it 2 years of age. I will not share my kingdom with anyone.
I will be the hate to your brother.
hate doing this. I gotta get my life together. Well, man's gotta make a living. Hurry, hurry, everybody. It's Jolly Jamboree's Jamboree and Retail Emporium, home of the finest merchandise this side of the River Nile, on sale today. Come on down. I got anything your heart desires, all for sale, and everything's priced to move. Everything must go. I need a customer. You, ma'am.
Yes?
Please come here. I have something that's going to wow you. I'm going to bring out the machine that's going to wow you. You're going to love this. Bothellini, Saccolini. And I'm giving you first look-see because we're like brother and sister. Trust me. Look what I got for you. Look what I got for you. I got some low-mileage cheer wine. I got some Mandalorian Baby Yoda socks. Very fashionable. Totally today, yet tremendously timeless. Okay. I'll try again. Here you go. Here you go. Rolling Thunder European Regularity Tonic. Use it sparingly.
No.
Okay, I'll give that to my... I'll give it to my mother-in-law. Satchel? What?
What about your satchel that you're wearing?
My set? What, yep. What, this?
Yes, that.
You want to buy this?
Yeah, I mean, it's got a few holes in it, but it's okay.
You want to buy this?
Yeah, I've got 5 shillings I can do.
Oh, well, ma'am, I mean, something of this quality, I couldn't possibly let this go for less than 15 shillings. I mean, this is genuine Ricardo Montalban leather taken from the seat of a 78 Cordoba. I mean, this you can't find. You can't find this just anywhere. And don't worry about the holes.
You can forget that. It's clearly not worth 15 shillings.
No, it's distressed. It's a thing. It's retro. People with money buy things that are purposely made to look old.
I've never heard of that before.
Yeah, I know. But see, it's a thing. It's part of the Kanye West collection. What do you say?
I don't think I'm interested in that. Thank you anyway.
Oh, but you do want it.
I do want it.
You want to buy it.
I do want to buy it.
It's the best looking pouch you've ever seen.
That's the best looking pouch I've ever seen.
Yes, you want to purchase it for 20 shillings.
20 shillings?
Yeah, want to purchase it for 20 shillings.
I do want to purchase it for 20 shillings.
And for 5 more shillings, you're going to buy the regularity tonic.
And for 5 more shillings, yes.
The regularity tonic.
Yes, I will
And
take
give it
them.
To your mother-in-law.
Both.
Yes.
Okay.
There you are.
Sure, take it all.
Okay. You're so happy with your purchase, you're going to skip all the way home clucking like a chicken.
That makes sense, yes. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Yes, indeed. Uh-huh. You've still got it, Jamborees. You've still got it.
That was easy.
We need to purchase our sacrifice for the temple before leaving Egypt, just in case we run out of money before reaching Jerusalem. We can't afford to show up empty-handed for something so important.
You're right. But we have to be quick, because we don't want to draw attention, because we've got to be on time to the temple for the purification ritual.
Yes, we can't have the Son of God being late now, can we?
Shh, Mary. Don't overhear.
I just couldn't help but overhear.
What'd I just say?
I'm sorry, did you just call your child the Son of God? Come, don't be shy.
Yes.
Come, it's Jolly Jamborees. Come on, don't be shy.
You heard correctly, but you mustn't tell anyone that you saw us, please.
And what would make you think that your son is divine?
An angel of the Lord came to me while Joseph and I were still to be married and told me that I was going to bear a child.
An angel again.
And that he would be the savior of the world, God's only son.
This was in Bethlehem. Bethlehem is where it happened, yes? Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Well, that must have been some message to receive. I can only imagine.
How do you think I felt?
I'm saying.
But indeed, what the angel spoke to me came to pass, and now he has been born, but we are in hiding because of King Herod's decree. He's searching for our son.
So where are you heading now?
We're headed to Jerusalem, to the temple, so for a purification ritual. But first, we have to purchase pigeons and food for our travel.
I see. Well, how could you afford that?
Well, I have this gold looking glass thingamadoodle. It was gifted, so we're looking to maybe trade it for pigeons and food for travel.
Oh, I want to help you. Good quality. Maybe we could work out a trade. What if I were to provide everything you need in exchange for this little trinket? I'm talking about one trip to Jerusalem, 3 days of food, 2 turtle doves, and you want me to say it, don't you? Everything you need for the trip. Safe passage, the food, and the turtle doves for the sacrifice in exchange for this. Do we have an accord?
If you have those things to offer, that would be wonderful.
Do I have those things? You never know what an enchanter can produce. Oh, I'm sorry, I believe you said 2.
Thank you.
Oh, you're quite welcome. Let me pack.
Where these were concerns me where the food is.
Oh, I'm an enchanter. I have lots of places to hide food.
Well,
I know, it doesn't make you feel any
better.
Still
concerns me, but nevertheless, shall we go?
I think we shall. And on the way, do tell me more about this child. After you.
About the prophecies of Daniel.
Oh yeah, tell us about the time that you traveled to meet the Messiah.
Well, it was just a few years ago, seems like it might have been just a few minutes ago, that me and my friends followed the star in a quest to seek power for ourselves. Each of us in turn instead came to know the Messiah. I feel though that it cost me a very good friendship with my friend Jambres. It was unfortunate, but he did not want to admit that the Messiah was the one true God and King. So we parted ways, and all I could ever do was pray for him since then.
What about the power of peace and reconciliation?
Well, there is hope yet for my friend Jambres. We will continue to pray for him. And why don't we all pray for my friend Jambres? And while we're praying for him, are there any other prayer requests? Yes.
Well, my older sister and I, we used to be like best friends, but now she's always in her room and she's so angry all the time. And I think it's because she's not close with God anymore. And I feel like he's trying to call out to her, but she just won't listen.
It sounds like me and my friend Jambres, unfortunately, but we would indeed pray for your friend. Anyone else? Yes?
Well, you see, my friend, she's stopped talking with everyone, and she won't tell anyone if anything's wrong or what is wrong. And I don't know, it's just, I feel so lost and like I don't know what I can do to help. Do you think that, like your friend Jambres, we could pray for her?
Well, the Messiah has come to mend all things that are broken. We will definitely pray for your friend. Is there anyone else? Yes.
Well, actually, could you
pray for
me? I'd like to have a relationship with the Messiah.
I think that is something we should all strive for. Let us pray.
before. Don't they have one of those, like, electronic directory type things to know where we're at?
It's not a mall, Joseph.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Your child. Your son. May I see him? I'm sorry. Why are you here?
We are here to present our son to the Lord and to make a sacrifice as says the law of the Lord.
What is your son's name?
His name is Jesus.
Jesus. Yeshua. The Lord saves.
Yes.
May I hold
him? Josephine.
Please. Lord, you are king over all. And now you can let your servant depart in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation. You have prepared it in the sight of all nations, a light for the Gentiles and a glory for your people Israel. Blessed are you, parents of this holy child. This child will cause the rise and fall of many in Israel. He is a sign given to us from God. But many will speak against him. And you, a sword will pierce your own soul also. Are you prepared for the offering?
Yes.
This dove is for the burnt offering. For atonement. It will be a sweet, pleasing aroma to the Lord. This second dove is for the purification offering, for reconciliation. It will also be a sweet, pleasing fragrance to the Lord. You may now offer your prayers.
Lord, thank you for the gift you have given us, and in return, we give him back to you. Amen.
God bless you, and God bless this holy child.
Thank you. Joe, the frankincense.
Oh, yeah, here it is. Frankincense.
This is for a gift for the temple from us, as a pleasing aroma for the Lord.
This frankincense is a worthy gift, but the greatest gift you have brought is this holy child. He himself will be offered to the Lord as a sweet fragrance. He will be a mediator between God and man. May the Lord bless you and may his face shine upon you. Chambres. Chambres, is that you?
I'm sorry, are you talking to me?
It is I, Simeon. We met in the palace when you arrived in Jerusalem.
Oh, I don't think so. I'm sorry. I think you've got me confused with someone else.
This young boy, Jesus, he grew, filled with wisdom, and God's grace was bestowed upon him. Every year at the Passover, he would go to Jerusalem for the Passover festival with his family. He would sit with the teachers. He would listen. He would answer their questions. He was baptized by John, and he started his ministry at the age of 30. He called his disciples to follow him. He healed the sick. He healed the lame. He even healed the dead from the grave. Truly, Jesus is the Messiah, but not all saw that. Many hated him for who he is and for what he did. He modeled love, forgiveness, and sacrifice. Greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. I pray now for my friend Jambres, that he too will place his faith in Jesus.
I've aged 33 years in the last hour. Well, maybe I'll just sit down at this quaint little cafe and have a little bite, get my hand sanitizer there. Dusty roads and all. Why am I talking to myself? Happens when you get older, I guess.
Hello. Welcome to Nazareth Cafe. What? I'm sorry. Have we met?
I doubt that, ma'am.
I don't forget a face. I'm pretty sure. You know, there was a group of Magi that came through. They were looking for the newborn king, the Messiah. I even trusted my son to travel with them. It was about 30 plus years ago, and yet we don't look like we've aged today.
Now speak for yourself. It's not the years, it's the mileage.
I'm certain I know you.
I don't think you do. Could I just have like a pineapple punch, please?
Sure, I'll be right out with that.
Okay, thank you. This thing's wobbling a little bit. I need a sugar packet or something. And now I'm breaking things.
Oh.
Well, that can't be good.
Hi.
I think I broke your table. This nail fell out. I don't know. That was a good save. A 3-second rule. It's fine.
Is there anything else I can get for you?
No, just the pineapple punch. Thank you.
Certainly not to rush you. Take Mm-mm. your time, but we will be closing early today.
Early today? Well, that's kind of odd. The city's packed. This is one of the big Jewish festivals, right? The what do they call it? The Passover?
Right.
Why would you close early on a day when everybody's in town?
We certainly normally wouldn't close early on Passover. Definitely not with this many people in town. But this Passover is going to be different. You must have heard. There's going to be a crucifixion today.
Yeah, I think I did hear about that.
Yeah, the one they called Jesus of Nazareth, the mm-hmm. Son of God.
Oh, well, I've been hearing a lot of that. A lot of that. What would make you think this man is the Son of God?
Have time for a story?
Why not?
So, well, at the risk of TMI, not that long ago, I was afflicted with a terrible illness.
Really?
Yes.
Were you quarantined?
Not that time.
Not that time?
So, it was really bad. I actually bled for 12 straight years.
No kidding.
Yeah. No one could do anything to treat it. Everybody tried, but no answers anywhere. It was It was awful.
Yeah, I made a little mess there, sorry.
That's okay.
But then, it was probably about a year ago, I heard that Jesus was coming to town.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew he was my only hope. I mean, we had all heard of his wonders and his miracles. So I fought my way through the crowd, and man, was it crowded. Everybody was trying to get his attention. I'm pretty spunky, so.
I believe that.
I just pushed my way right on through the crowd, and I fell right at his feet. On purpose this time. Normally I just fall.
Well, what happened?
I did what I could, and I reached out, and I could just reach the hem of his garment. But in that instant, I was healed. And my life has changed in ways I just simply cannot describe.
Okay, but how do you know you were the only one healed? I mean, there's people all over the place. How do you know this really happened?
That's a solid question. But I don't know that I was the only one that was healed. But I know for me, it was my faith that made the difference. You see, when I reached out for him, when I reached to touch that garment, I was reaching, just knowing in my heart that God's power was what would heal me. You know, I'll never forget that moment when he felt me touch his garment among all of that crowd and bustle. He felt me touch his garment and he stopped the crowd. He looked for me. He told me himself. He said, it's your faith that has made you healed.
Okay, all right. Let's say everything you just said is true.
It is.
And he's the Son of God, right?
Correct.
Okay, so why would he be dying a criminal's death? And wouldn't he have the power to stop it if he's the Son of God?
Certainly. He absolutely has the power to stop it. But you know, he's choosing to let this happen. You said it's Passover, and today there will be a new lamb. You know, he's convicted of crimes he did not commit. His death was prophesied even before his birth. The reason he is dying today is simple. He's dying for us. He's dying for me, for you, for anyone that lived before us, and for those that are yet to be born. He is the perfect lamb being sacrificed for our sins. And for anyone who believes, so that they'll have everlasting life. You know, that day I was telling you about, that day, he did heal my physical life. He saved my physical life that day when he stopped my bleeding. But today he's gonna save my eternal life through his own. So you understand, I have to go. That's why we'll be closing early.
Okay. Take a minute and enjoy your drink.
Are you ready, Mother?
Absolutely not, but I suppose we must go.
Oh, hello, young man I've never met.
I'm sorry, I failed to introduce you. This is my son, Gaspar. He's actually the one I mistook you for, traveling with him so many years ago.
Ah, are you going to go with your mother to see this Jesus's crucifixion?
I am, yes. I was there to give him my frankincense at his birth. And now that his death is near, the least I can do is to offer to help carry his cross after all that he's done for me. You should come with us. This is an event that's so big that it will change the course of history.
What, like a royal wedding?
Yes, but much, much bigger than a royal wedding.
Well, It sounds like an ordeal and like it's going to be a scene and a half. I don't think there'd be anything there for me. But you go ahead and go.
Thank you for stopping in today. You know, the drink, well, it was on me, I'm sorry.
it's all right.
Do you mind just closing up when you get ready?
Oh, sure. Yeah, don't worry about it. I'll pull the door shut when I leave.
Thank you. I wish you'd consider coming. There's still time, and you could easily catch up to us.
Well,
you know, I think if you saw what I know is going to happen today, your heart would understand all of these truths. Thanks for coming back.
Okay.
Ah, yes. There you are. Take all of this down. No, not that thing. Yeah, the good quill, not that feather duster. Yes. Yes. I long suspected that he was the one that the wise men had sought. Yes. I had seen his miracles. He was patient with my pride. Yes. He came to me by night. On the rooftop of my villa, just outside the beltway there in Jerusalem. You know the one, yes. You've been there. Anyway, yeah. He told me that I must be born of water and spirit. Born again, if you will. And in a very real sense, I was. But it wasn't then. No, it was the night that he was killed. Yes, yes, the night he was killed. He was betrayed. And then crucified, and they nailed him to that cross. You were there, you remember?
Yes, I was there. Surely he was the Son of God.
Surely, yes. And Joseph?
Yes. Not Joseph of Nazareth?
No. Joseph of Arimathea.
Yes, Joseph of Arimathea here. Yes. Although he may look a little like Joseph of Nazareth.
I get that a lot.
Yes. Anyway, back to what we were doing. Yes. Joseph and I, we took his body from the cross that night. Yes, and we took it to Joseph's freshly cut tomb. And there we laid his body. I personally brought 75 pounds of spices and myrrh from my own collection. I felt so unworthy to embalm our Lord and Savior, but there I was. Oh. If I had only known what that star had meant all those years ago, I would have followed it. And those ridiculous magi. Yes, I would have went with them to Bethlehem. I would have worshipped our Lord there at the manger. And I would have followed him all of my days. Yes, come. There is more to be written yet. I know a man named John. Let's go.
Mary? Mary, it's Jambres. Why are you crying? What's wrong?
I just went to the tomb of my son's body, and it's gone.
Somebody took Jesus' body? Oh, I'm
no.
So sorry. That's all.
No,
why
no,
would
no.
they do such a thing?
No, don't be sorry. You must not understand.
Oh, no, I understand. You just told me somebody took his body.
No, I didn't say they took his body. I said his body is gone. We knew that this was going to happen. But it's just seeing it now is so unbelievable.
No, you knew this was going to happen. You were in on taking his body?
No.
You're not making sense,
no,
Mary.
No,
okay, a breath. But come and just rest a minute. And is that, okay, tell me everything.
I know I must be speaking in circles, Jambres. I brought this myrrh to the tomb just to put it on Jesus' body, and his body was gone. Jambres, he told us that this would happen. He told us that he would be the one to defeat death.
Well, no, wait a minute. You are telling me that it's not just Jesus' body is gone, but Jesus himself is... No, that's ridiculous.
No, it's true.
Now, Mary, now look, you have to face some facts. All right, I was there. I saw the nails. I saw him brutalized. I saw him bleed. I saw him give up his spirit. And then I saw him taken down and put in that tomb. I saw it all, Mary. And I'm sorry I'm being blunt, but I know this is your son. That people don't come back from that, Mary.
I know.
They don't.
People don't, Jambres. But he did. You're right. He is my son. I was there too. I saw what they did to him too. But nothing is impossible with God. Don't you remember all those years ago I learned that when the angel told me that God blessed me with Jesus? Jambres, there was even a reason for meeting you. It was to fulfill the prophecy from the prophet that spoke long ago that said, out of Egypt I call my son. You helped us escape from King Herod. And now he has given us the greatest gift of all life everlasting. It's such good news.
But how does life come out of death? That goes against everything I've ever studied, everything I've ever known.
I know. It's a difficult thing to understand. It's like this myrrh. It's used as a burial preservative. It's a spice for death. But did you know that when you put it on a wound, or even pour it on the ground, it becomes like a healing agent? Thank you. It's like what was once used for death can now bring life, in a sense. It heals the wounds, it fertilizes the ground, it creates growth.
Okay, oh, all right. But
look.
But why?
Like
would
this
he
vessel
do this?
Is empty, he emptied himself for us to give us life.
Well, but okay. Let's say all of that is true. But why would he do that? Why would he go through what I saw?
You already know the answer to that.
Yeah, but I can understand maybe for his own people.
But for us, he loves you. He loves me. Jambres, go and see the tomb. It's empty. Go and see for yourself. Go and see. Go. It's time, Jambres. Open your eyes. God, I know. Come to us for a reason. God, help him in his unbelief. Help today be the day of salvation.
Dearest Melchior, it's been a long time since we've seen each other, and I heard you were going to be in the city soon. I was wondering if you could stop by my place. There's something I want to discuss with you about my old friend Jambres.
I'd like to talk and reminisce about the time went on our quest to find the Messiah. I want to remember and pray for Jambres, that he may also place his faith in Jesus.
Solid gold. riches that could buy my dreams. You are better than all these things. The prettiest face to turn their eyes. Beauty that could hypnotize. The open doors that looks may bring. You are better than all these.
I brought him myrrh. He granted to me eternal life.
I gave him gold. I sought earthly riches. He gave me eternal prosperity.
Oh, I know you are.
I gave him my frankincense, and he made my life a pleasant aroma for the Lord.
I gave him my praise and worship, and he gave me the hope of salvation for all people.
I sought righteousness under the law. He gave me freedom from the law.
I have served many kings, but now I serve the one true king.
Gave him my tomb. He literally took my place.
I spent a lifetime trying to get everyone's order right. But when I put my faith in him, he put my life in the right order.
Jesus, my sweet son,
I gave him my heart and soul. Touched me with a love that I have never known.
Like everyone, all I really had to offer Jesus was my sin, which he forgave, and my life, which he saved. And I'll follow him all the days of my life as he gives me the power to do it. What will you do with this Jesus.
So at the heart of this story, I wanted to portray the message of friendship for friends who were seeking Jesus for all the wrong reasons, for their own selfish gain. But then every step along the way, they came a bit closer to the knowledge of the truth. And we believe that those who seek Jesus finds truth, and they're never the same again. If you put your hope in Jesus, you also find life everlasting, not just for this life, not just for eternal life, but for this life, hope in this life here and now. So the three gifts that the wise men brought to Jesus, they were not by random, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, but each tell a story of the hope we have in Christ. So gold represents his royalty and divinity. He is our king that will rule with justice and mercy, with power and glory, and he is worthy to be praised. So in the story, I wanted to portray the gift of gold as a looking glass into the future, because a lot of time we use wealth as a way of seeking our self-value. We use gold as a way of seeking security and seeking vision, but a lot of times that's what blinds us. And so if Jesus is our rich king, he is our ruler, then we can lay down our insecurities before him. And he is more precious than gold. And frankincense represents his appointment and anointment. He is our high priest that stands in our place. He is our advocate. He is our representative. So in the play, obtaining frankincense was a way of reaching a higher status to gain favor and approval by mother. And we believe that those people who seek self-value and seek their own worth from their achievements will fall short. The Bible says, if you strive for your own righteousness, you'll fall short of the glory of God. And if Jesus is your righteousness, then you have the right standing with God. Because we are not worthy of reaching God, so he came down to receive us. Our life was a stench to him, so he sent Jesus, and his life was a pleasing aroma to the Lord. So have you accepted Jesus as your righteousness? And it was him and his work that is your righteousness before God. And it's not by our own, but what Jesus has done for us on the cross. And lastly, myrrh. Myrrh represents his sacrifice and our salvation, showing us that he is the final prophet. He is the final prophet sent from God to proclaim his death and resurrection. The truth is, we will all die one day. None of us are immortal. And so we will return to dust again. The Bible says that that's because of the curse of sin upon us. But the message of Christmas shows us that there is life after death. That's what myrrh represents. Myrrh is a burial spice, but it also is a healing agent. In order to obtain myrrh, you have to cut deep wounds into its tree and let the sap bleed out. So like myrrh, the Bible says that Jesus was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquity. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and through his wounds, we are healed. And so the question remains, like myrrh, have you died to self? Have you repented of your sins and received the gift of eternal life? And that is the hope that we have in the gospel. That is the good news of Christmas to all people. And so if you have received this message, you've heard it, God calls us to respond to him. It's a choice because it's a free gift. And I believe that you can respond in one of three ways, everyone. Number one, you hear it and reject it. And if that's you, that's fine. We're glad that you're here, because no one is forced into the kingdom. And number two, you can receive it and embrace it. And if that is you, let us know. And maybe you receive it for the first time so we can celebrate with you, because God calls us to do this in community. And number three, if you are a Christian, you are able to hear this message, It calls for a celebration. It calls for to praise and to proclaim it to the world, right? Because you found yourself in the story. And like the wise men, you have a gift to bring, to offer. And like the shepherds, you have to tell the world.